Hey guys, it's Glenn from glennscarcollection.com, and now I'm going to give you guys an update on the McLaren. To rock and roll. Now, we haven't done an update on the McLaren in a little bit. I gotta have my seatbelt on. So let's do one. All right, so I've had this car close to a year already. I've put over 3,000 miles on it. And in this video, you'll learn what I like about the car, what I don't like about the car, and most importantly, is it reliable? Now, unfortunately, Bergen County, New Jersey, even the nice towns have these horrible streets, so the bumping is actually from the roads. It's bumping in any car I drive, not just the McLaren. So that's the first thing let's talk about is the ride. The ride is actually pretty good. I would say, you know, it's not a Lexus, but the ride I would say is equal to my BMW M2. So a little stiff like a sports car, but it's a lot smoother ride. I recently drove a 991 GT3, 991.2 manual with a 4.0, 500 horsepower, and my friend's 997.2 GT3, and they're way stiffer than this car. So I was talking to a friend today at a Cars and Coffee, and he said him and his wife like to go on long trips. This is a great long trip car. So it actually, the suspension is compliant. I just drove an hour from an event, and you know, I'm still refreshed. My back still feels good, unlike my Lotus. So it is a really, really good car. Go around these pedestrians here. So it can be a good road trip car. Now, this is the S model, so it's a little loud in here and a little stiffer. If you really want to use it as a daily driver, say like the new NSX, in that car you can see our reviews for the 2019-2017. That's more of a daily driver because it's softer. So the GT is quieter. Unfortunately, GT doesn't have the quick steering that the McLaren S has. Has a lot more sound deadening, so it's a quieter, more comfortable car. It has the glass roof. The glass roof to me gets really hot in the summer. Here it's very humid in the summer, so I definitely noticed the difference. I test drove a GT a couple times before I decided on the S. The S is lighter, 200 pounds lighter, and a more sharper experience. For YouTube, the GT may be better because with the glass, I can put a GoPro here where I have a lot more light in this cabin. But for driving experience, I much prefer the S, so go for the S. What other cars did I consider? You know, I was in that 165 price range, which is still about what this car is worth, so it didn't depreciate too much in this first year. Test drove the 458. The 458 in that price range is a 2011, so the dual clutch wasn't that good yet. If you buy a 458, you want a 2012 or newer, because that's when they did a lot of updates to the car, including revising the dual clutch. Another competitor was the Huracan. I think the Huracan sounds even better. This car sounds good, but the Huracan sounds even better because it's a normally aspirated engine and it's a 10-cylinder. So at full wheel at 8,000 RPM sounds incredible. Handling is not as good as this. It's not as sharp as a driver's car. Dual clutch isn't as good as this. So I prefer, and actually the Huracan that I liked, and there's a video on this channel, is the 580-2. I much preferred the rear drive Huracan than the all-wheel drive. To me, the all-wheel drive car had a lot of understeer. The rear drive was way more playful. So this is like the Huracan times two if you just go by handling and dual clutch. Doesn't have the sound. The sound is still very good, but it doesn't have the sound as a normally aspirated V10. What else? Servicing costs, they're pretty good for this car. The way to buy this car is to buy certified pre-owned through a McLaren dealer. So this is a 17. I didn't want a first year car, so that ruled out 2016 S's. I wanted it to be a second year car so they could get out all the bugs out of it. And I wanted to buy from a McLaren dealer, and not all cars at the dealer are qualified. So you gotta make sure it's a McLaren qualified car where you can get the McLaren bumper to bumper warranty. So this car brand new has a 3-year warranty. I believe it's unlimited miles. I just finished that third year of warranty, and now I'm on my fourth year because I have 1 year of qualified. Now you can extend that warranty. I think it's $3,800. And you can go up to 12 years. So this car can be warranted until the year 2029, which is really incredible. Now gas mileage, who cares about gas mileage? If you're into the turbos going fast and really accelerating, it'll get terrible gas mileage just like any other car. But if you drive in seventh gear on the highway, I put it in auto mode and leave it in seventh gear on the highway, going whatever speed, probably over the speed limit, and it actually will get really good mileage. So I just got about 290 miles from a tank on the highway. Now driving around town, it tells me, you know, I'm going to get like 190 driving around town if I'm driving it into the turbos. But if you stay out of the turbos, it'll get decent mileage, good mileage actually. But what's the fun of that? So go into the turbos. You bought this car to drive, so definitely burn some gas for sure. Would I buy this car again? 1,000%. I like this more than the 720S. 720S, I'll say, is the best car ever and the fastest car I ever drove. But I can tell you, this is more fun. This is the driver's car. There's no electronic suspension. There's no aero. This car is incredible. This is the one to buy. So we'll do a little acceleration here when the road clears out. So I'm going to do track throttle, which gives me this cool screen that you've seen in my other videos, but still the comfort suspension. Amazing. I was short shifting there. So if you go, the red lights like a Formula One car, go green, red, and blue. And obviously it's just incredible. You feel like you're driving a Formula One car. You really do. You know, at that $160,000 price point, I think it's the best car you could buy. You can really get an exotic car. I would take this over the new NSX. The new NSX to me is still a daily driver. I love the 2019. I think they made a lot of tweaks to it, but still, this is the car. This is the car to get for sure. So what do I like about the car? Well, I love the looks. I care less about looks. I'd rather have performance and handling. So the best things about this car is the handling, really the sharp steering and the grip that this car has, especially for a rear drive car, is incredible. The acceleration is phenomenal. Probably one of the fastest cars I ever drove, sans the new Ford GT and the 720S. Gearbox is incredible. And I love that it's rear drive. And then what I don't like about the car, I still like manual transmission cars. If I change one thing, I would say make it slower and make it a stick shift. That's never going to happen, so I really have no dislikes. Biggest thing with these cars, are they reliable? You hear horror stories. Really, the 12C was unreliable, and a little bit of the 650S with those electronic suspensions failing and costing the owner $40,000. The 570S, they took all that stuff out that could go wrong. It made this a more analog car, and I think overall they're very reliable. So I still would skip a 2016, which is the first year for the 570S, and only stick to a 2017. And I'm telling you, if you get a 2017 used, qualified from a McLaren dealer under warranty, it'll be one of the most reliable cars you've ever owned. This, honestly, is one of the most reliable cars I've ever owned. I live in New Jersey. I could drive to California. I drive to Florida, and I'd have zero problems. Little acceleration. Whoa! At first gear, it kind of struggles for grip. So that first second, you get a little sideways, like the Hellcat Red Eye that I've driven, but then the traction control takes over and makes you look like a hero. But yeah, buy a 570S, guys. Try to get, you know, when you buy a car used, try to buy a car fully loaded. So I looked at cars, and they come in all different colors. You know, originally I wanted blue or orange or something, and a lot of these cars are spec'd with minimal options. You want a car that's spec'd with all the options, like this one. This had an original sticker of $245. It's got $50,000 in carbon fiber. It's got this $4,000 carbon fiber steering wheel with the shift pedals. That's like a $35,000 or $4,000 option. It's got the stereo. It's got the front lift. It's got the sport exhaust. So to me, the stereo, in no particular order, the front lift, the sport exhaust, and the carbon fiber shift paddles were must-haves, those four options. This is literally the only car I found with all four of those options. And it doesn't add any of the value. Or fully loaded like this one, they'll sell for the same price as McLaren dealer. So spend the money. You're ready. The first owner had $100,000 in depreciation. You'll have a little depreciation, but maybe $10,000, $20,000 a year. This is a supercar performance. It's comfortable. It's great for long trips. You got a front lift. You got the carbon fiber paddles. To me, that's a must-have. Of all those options I mentioned, that and the sport exhauster must-have. You probably need the front lift as well in the stereos just because I like music. If I'm sitting in traffic or behind a slow car like now, I like to hear my tunes. All right, guys, so this is a must-buy, the 570S. Please buy one if you ever get the chance. And I'll see you next time. Remember to subscribe and hit that notification bell. Like and share this video so our channel can grow. And as always, leave a positive comment below. And we post 3 videos. Let's do acceleration. Hold on. Whoa. Holy crap. Woo. That was fast. That was a second gear pull. All right. Whatever. Like and share these videos. Leave a positive comment below. Remember to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss a video. We post 3 videos a week. Every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 7 a.m. And we got a lot of... I'm going to a press day coming up this week. And I have some amazing videos that will be coming over the next couple of months. So you'll definitely want to subscribe. Thanks again, guys. And I will see you next time.